Today's Labor Thanksgiving Day. There's no school. Wow. First things first. There we go. Fix that right away. So, full disclosure, I'll be honest with you. While I've been enjoying the game, and I have been enjoying the game, I've been asking myself what all the hype is, because a lot of people are marking that that Persona 3 is like the best of the Persona series. I disagree. I feel that's kind of a toss-up between 4 and 5. I feel like, honestly, they had better, like, they told the story better. But I can see why a lot of people feel that 3 is superior now. It's specifically to do with Junpei's arc. His arc is fantastic. He goes from a guy who's just regular teenage boy. All he can think about is girls, all he can think about is glory and power, and he goes from that person who got so jealous of MC or Femcy, where he was bitter, to basically not caring about any of that and wanting to protect the people that he cares about. I mean, he's always wanted to protect the people that he cares about. It's just, it's always been a secondary or tertiary objective, or something that's linked in with what he's doing. So yeah, no, Junpei's character's handled really, really well. Again, well, I'll get into my thoughts overall in the game later, but yeah, no, I really enjoy Junpei's character arc here. I haven't seen Junpei around, but I know he's gonna be okay. I wonder what Strega is. They couldn't have come from nowhere. Someone must have created them. I wonder what that person was thinking. Couldn't he foresee that this would happen? She was the first girl Junpei's ever been serious about. Do you think he'll be okay? I don't know. Oh, don't say that. You're making me nervous. A top priority of all human beings is the preservation of their own lives. But Chidori-san gave her life force to Junpei-san. There was a connection between them that transcended space and time. She was taking those drugs as well. If she hadn't died now, she most likely would have died soon. But fate chose the most beautiful way to end her life. No, Mitsuru, I don't think fate had anything to do with that. That was Chidori's choice. Junpei-kun and Chidori-san were so close. I know they're still together now, but I never thought it would end like this. You drew a fortune, hoping to deepen the bond between you. You hear a divine message. Blessings to the believer. You feel closer to Junpei. Today's luck is, according to the fortune, you will have bad luck. Be careful with your money. 1,000 yen just flew out of your pocket and blew away. Wow.
Hello.
Junpei-san still in his room. It's hard to lose someone you're so close to. I'm worried about him. Yeah, let's go check on him. Chances are he'll probably tell us that he wants us to leave him alone, but all the same. Junpei seems to be in his room, but he isn't responding. Oh, yep, see?
How can I help? These people already have plans, so they can't go tonight.
Junpei. You know what? I'm gonna save. But we're not gonna go to Tartarus tonight. I'm actually gonna make another save just in case. Because I wanna see if Junpei actually can. And I'm giving myself until the 28th. Because I have quests to hand in. If he doesn't come around before the 28th, I'll reload to the 23rd and just go to Tartarus. The next 4 days are career experience days. Iwatarai Strip Mall Wild Duck Burger. You will help clean here for the next 4 days. The amount of trash is unbelievable. Yeah, no kidding. The garbage is overflowing with food that expired and had to be tossed out. Iwatarai Strip Mall Wild Duck Burger. Today is the last day of career experience. From what the manager tells you, many of the ingredients used are imported from developing countries. Some regions seem to have become rich due to the exports. You feel as if you learned something important that cannot be easily dismissed as a wasted week. Your academics has significantly increased. Wow! You stopped by Chagall Cafe on your way back from school. Ryoji called you over. Polonia Mall, Chagall Cafe. I'm sorry to call you over without warning. Am I interrupting anything important? Nah, I'm alright. I see. Ryoji seems relieved. I was in the same group as Junpei-kun, but he never showed up at the beginning. He only came on one of the days because the teacher said that he had to. Something seemed really strange about him, though. I'd talked to him, but he didn't seem like he was listening at all. He looked like he was about to cry. Did something happen? Yeah. Should I not ask about it? Ryoji looks down sadly. Junpei-kun is someone I care about. That's why I'm worried. I've never seen him this way before. I wonder if there's anything that I can do. Can you revive the dead? You sense Ryoji's deep concern for Junpei. You feel that you've come to understand Ryoji a little better now. And we are at rank 7. The Ryoji Mochizuki social link has reached level 7. Your power to create personas of the Fortune Arcana has grown. You spent time with Ryoji, but little was said.
Hello.
Hello. Junpei-san still not feeling well. I'm getting really worried now. After all he's been through, I can understand why he's feeling down. He got really lucky this week, though. No one realized he took some days off because everyone was at career experience. Well, I hope he's feeling a little better now. I'm gonna defeat those striker guys. I can't take this anymore. I know how you feel. But you don't have to do it all by yourself. I know. And we finished off with the monk. And it's not one of Ken's days, sadly. So I guess we'll just go to bed. Your condition improved because you rested. Your cell phone rang. Good morning. This is Theodore. There is a human, three of them actually, wandering around Tartarus. Please carry out a search and rescue. Goodbye now. The call ended. Well, that settles it. We're going to Tartarus tonight. Blessings to the believer. You get closer to Hidetoshi. Today's luck is, according to the fortune, you will have fair luck. money will also be in your fortune. You just found 1,000 yen. Probably the one that blew away the other day. The dormitory lounge. Mitsuru called everyone together once they got home.
Cheer up, Junpei.
Not the right thing to say to somebody who's grieving, dude.
Yeah. So what do you want?
This came for you. It's from the hospital.
Mitsuru handed something to Junpei.
Is this Chidori's sketchbook?
They were going through her items when they found that.
Oh. I know I have to snap out of this, but it's just so hard.
All of these are garbage. Cheer up, Junpei. He just had a, he just suffered a family, he just suffered a personal loss. And he just said he knows how to snap out. He knows he has to snap out of it, but it's hard. I know how you feel. Yeah, technically, I do know how he feels in the matter of the story because Kitone lost her parents, but it's not the same. It's not the same thing. And come on, be a man is just insensitive. So.
Yeah.
Hey, Junpei, can I take a look?
You wouldn't be able to understand her drawings anyways.
Eh? Yukari slowly opens the sketchbook.
Wait, is this? Wow, it's really good. This is amazing. Who wouldn't be able to understand it?
Junpei peeked into the sketchbook.
Uh-huh. Is this?
It's a detailed portrait of Junpei-san. The next page, and the next. Every page is devoted to Junpei.
Chidori. Junpei. It's like she's telling me to stop moping around.
She must be looking out for you.
Hey. I promised to fight to get rid of the dark hour. I'm usually just looking out for number one. So it's been hard for me sometimes to accept that you're our leader, but... I'm sorry. I want you to know. I've got nothing but faith in your skills.
I'm counting on you, too.
Glad to hear it. Let's keep rocking together, leader.
Aw. You shook Junpei's hand firmly.
Junpei.
Your friends are smiling with tears in their eyes. You sense a strong bond with them. Rank 9. The C's social link has reached level 9. Your power to create personas of the Fool Arcana has grown. And yeah, so holding off on Tartarus proved to be a good idea. Because guess where we're going tonight? So everybody is pretty much close. So I'll put Junpei in the party, Mitsuru, and Aigis. And then we'll have to switch them out at some point for Koromaru and Ken. And then we can finally put Yukari and Akihiko back in the party as well.
2 hours later.
There's someone on this floor. Find them, please. Two enemies. It has multiple weaknesses. Two enemies left.
Just prowling, no tangling, no tangling.
to enemies. It seems the enemies... One enemy left!
I'm going too!
Here's our chance! Let's do it!
Just like music samples.
Is that one of the ones who went missing? We need to treat them as soon as possible. Please come back to the entrance immediately.
Return to the entrance for the person who was reported missing? Yep.
It's a good thing you were able to find the missing person. They're resting in a safe place now. You can go on and keep exploring if you want.
20 minutes later.
There are 3 shadows in the middle. Be careful. Good luck.
I think I know what these are weak to, but...
This is not just a random shadow. It seems to be guarding this area.
Yeah, no shit.
Give me a sec. I'll scan the target.
Now let's see if I'm right. Nope. One more thing. Well, she tried Maboo-Boon, but that's fine. But, let's try this one. See how that goes.
Nice! Do it again! Persona!
Now's our chance. Let's go.
Sure.
The enemies return to normal.
Well, shit.
It must be eliminated. Defense weakened. Please be careful. Here.
Guess we're using one of these.
Proceeding! The enemy is still alive! I summon you!
Nice evasion.
Hang in there.
It was not. But thank you.
Proceeding. It must be eliminated. Defense weakened. Please be careful. Here.
Oh, damn.
Hang in.
Literally just healed you, kid.
Please help me! Persona! One more to go. I command thee.
Oh, I'm surprised you didn't charge and start hitting.
Oh, crap. Locking on.
They're not.
Enemy annihilated.
Three dense rocks. And a precious egg.
1 hour later.
There's someone on this floor. Find them, please. Watch out! There are four enemies.
Persona! Awesome.
There's one enemy. Persona! That's the way. Here's our chance. Let's do it. Understood.
And I got the claymore, which is not worth it, sadly.
Two enemies. Persona!
Been a little rough. Fast while you just proud. Time for me, no tangling.
An attack! There are three of them! Please help me!
Been a little round, but I'm still battling. Move
the there are three enemies left! Kikurihime! The enemy is down! Again. Now's your chance! Two enemies. It's time to get serious. Denkun defeated an enemy.
You're on a roll.
Move fast while you just fell and no time. No tangle. Damn.
With no angle. This ends now. Such resistance.
Target locked.
You must be in the
rectangles.
Persona! It's time to get serious.
Really?
This ends now! You're unworthy of my time.
Is that one of the ones who went missing? We need to treat them as soon as possible. Please come back to the entrance immediately.
Return to the entrance with the person who was reported missing? Yep.
It's a good thing you were able to find the missing person. They're resting in a safe place now. You can go on and keep exploring if you want.
Yep, that's exactly what we're gonna do.
1 hour later.
It seems you've completed a request. One moment, please, while I check. I see you've brought 3 moon tablets, as I requested. Thank you. You will gradually encounter stronger shadows as you ascend Tartarus. The floors that you will be exploring next are populated with very strong monsters. Please keep this in mind. Please take this as your reward. Obtained a space pad.
5 minutes later.
I sense three enemies in the middle of the floor. Be careful, okay?
Three enemies? Does that mean that we're not near the top?
Good luck!
Be ready! I sense it's a strong one! Give me a sec. I'll scan the target.
Out. Megadola.
I summon you. Persona. It must be eliminated. Hang in.
Oh boy.
Must be eliminated. This ends remain.
Watch this!
Locking on. One more to go.
This ends now.
Woo.
My will is unfailing.
So yeah, Megidola saved my ass. Yeah, so we're not doing that again.
1 hour later.
I sense a strong presence on the 190th floor. Please be careful.
There's someone on this floor. Find them, please. It has multiple weaknesses. There are four enemies left! Enemy defeated!
Incredible!
Such persistence. One enemy to go! Last one. Don't let your guard down. Let us commence with an all-out attack. Fatal strike. There's one enemy.
You're unworthy of my time.
One of the ones who went missing? We need to treat them as soon as possible. Please come back to the entrance immediately.
Return to the entrance with the person who is reported missing? Yep.
It's a good thing you were able to find the missing person. They're resting in a safe place now. You can go on and keep exploring if you want.
That is exactly what we will do, Fuka.
5 minutes later.
It seems you've completed a request. One moment, please, while I check. I see you brought 6 pink feathers, as I requested. Thank you. These pink wings are adorable. I thought they would be. If you had these on your back, it'd look completely natural.
Excuse you?
Thank you very much. I will take good care of these. Please take this as your reward.
I've obtained the Berserker Seal.
1 hour later.
There's one shadow near the middle of the floor. It's really strong, so be careful.
Oh boy.
Here it comes.
It's Arcana, is the Hermit. This will be a tough battle. Give me a sec. I'll scan the target.
Oh boy.
I command thee! I failed to fin. Watch this!
Please help me! Proceeding!
Nice.
Let us commence with an all-out attack.
Let's.
Fatal strike!
Again.
Let us commence with an all-out attack. Fatal strike.
Excellent.
I command thee.
Probably won't work, but oh wow, it did. Good job, Ken.
Here's our chance. Let's do it.
Understood.
So not as tough as I thought it was going to be. We got a homunculus too. That's awesome. Something inside of you has changed. Haridi has leveled up. Nice. Oh, and Samaricarm. Going to save the game.
Something seems different about the enemies in this area. I'll scan ahead, but it might take a little while.
20 minutes later.
Rest. One moment, please, while I check.
I see you've brought 2 gold medals, as I requested. Thank you. I have a very special reward for you this time. A rocket-propelled metal fist. It's not possible for a human to use it. But one of your party members might be able to. Please take this as your reward.
So a weapon for Agus, a rocket punch. Oh, but rocket punch is less than Kiss of Athena. So, well.
1 hour later.
I sense 3 shadows in the middle. Please be careful. Good luck!
This one's dangerous! Stay focused! Give me a sec. I'll scan the target.
Nice.
Yes, even
the enemy's down. Attack again.
Nice. I will follow suit.
Good.
Let us commence with an all-out attack.
Turn one all-out attack is always great.
Fatal strike.
I mean, I don't need the healing, but thank you.
This ends now!
I failed to... Locking on. The enemy is still alive. Damaged!
Wow, you only have Mia? Really? Oh.
Mitsura-senpai can't use her persona! I summon you!
Witch Bliss!
Such persistence. When you fall, get right back up. Target locked. An unexpected turn of events.
And done.
The enemy is getting stronger too.
They absolutely are. And a broken heart, okay. Let's see what goodies we've got. Just the one, okay. Eh, it's fresh steak. I'll take it.
Something's different about the enemies around here. I'll scan ahead. It might take some time though.
20 minutes later.
I sense a really powerful shadow near the middle. Please be careful, okay? Good luck!
Its arcana is fortune. This will be a difficult fight. Give me a sec. I'll scan the target.
In effect.
Witch Bliss.
Target locked. Must be eliminated.
Okay.
This ends now!
be eliminated.
I can play that game too, asshole. Oh, sweet. You
the
met her.
Enemy's down. Let's finish this. You'll fall by my hand. This ends now. That wasn't good.
Oh, sweet! Displaying adaptability. Oh, that won't work. That won't work either. Well, shit. Oh!
The enemy's down!
Let us commence with an all-out attack. Fatal strike!
Thank you.
My will is unfailing.
Kalanemi is now 67. Well, that certainly was something. I got Soma. And two attack mirrors for my efforts. Now to go heal.
1 minute later.
For some reason, there are way fewer enemies in that area.
Well, it's about fucking time. That means that we are nearing the top of this area.
It's a dead end. I see the way to the next floor, but the path is blocked. I wonder why.
Obtained old document 08. I'm leaving the team. I can't break the law. But he won't come with me. Maybe I'll open an antique store. Interesting.
It seems you've completed a request.
One moment, please, while I check.
It seems you retrieved the old document from Haraba. That will be the last document I will ask you to find. I wanted you to learn the truth by reading these 8 documents. However, you are already moving towards another truth. Memories may show you the past, but you are always moving towards the future. I must admit, I'm a bit jealous, since I have neither myself.
Please take this as your reward. Wow, that's a lot of money. Thank you. Now that's out of the way, we have some leveling up to do with other characters. Mitsuru, Aegis, and Ken are okay for now. So I still got to work on Yukari, Junpei, Akihiko, and Koromaru.
So much later that the old narrator got tired of waiting and they had to hire a new one.
Oh, Junpei's not even here. Okay. So, after an 8-hour slog, we have finally managed to level basically everybody up. The only exception is Junpei, who I didn't realize wasn't even here, despite the fact that Fuka said that everyone could go to Tartarus tonight. In other words, she fucking lied to me. Didn't actually mean to talk to you, but that was nice to know. Well, we're gonna have to make do as it is. We'll have to play catch up with Junpei later. But for the meantime, after 8 fucking hours of this shit, it's time to leave. So let's get the fuck out of here. There is no school today. Your phone is ringing. Hello, this is Mochitsuki Ryoji. This is Katone-chan, right? Do you have some time to spare? Yep. Why don't we go out somewhere? The weather's great. Since you have the fortune persona, Fortuna, you might be able to become even closer. What should you do? Yep. That's great. Just thinking about seeing you makes me happy. I'll head over immediately. Ryoji seems excited. Ryoji took you to the school. Together, you climbed over the gates and quietly made your way to the rooftop. Gekkogan High Rooftop. I wonder if we'll get in trouble if someone finds us. Eh, probably. I'm sorry. I wanted to see the ocean. Ryoji seems somewhat sad. Oops. When I'm alone, I don't feel right. I think I'm scared. Thinking about you, it scares me. The fact that tomorrow will come scares me. But I can't figure out why. Hey, Katone-chan. I'm... You're Ryoji. Hearing my name from your lips makes it sound so wonderful. Thank you. Ryoji gives you a warm smile. I don't want to lose you. Because you're important to me. That's probably why I'm scared.
You're the only one there is for me.
Okay.
The only one I want. So please, stay with me.
Is Ryoji confessing his love for you? You feel that you need to respond carefully to this. As a friend, then. Anything's fine. I'll be your friend as long as I can stay by your side. You're the most precious thing in the world to me. More precious than my own life. Ryoji laughs gently. You sense that you have a bond with Ryoji. This can't be the max already. No, it's ranked 8. Okay, we've still got 2 more. The Ryoji Mochitsuki social link has reached level 8. Your power to create personas of the Fortune Arcana has grown. Katone-chan, look! The ocean's glimmering. Why does it hurt when I see things that are so beautiful? It's so strange. You spend some time with Ryoji, then return to the dorm before the two of you were caught up there.
Oh, hey!
Hi. The moon's almost full here. No shadows have appeared yet, but I'm still worried. Me too. Junpei's got a smile on his face now. Now that's the Junpei I know. She drew a picture of him in her sketchbook, huh? That sounds like a scene from an inner romance novel. Anyway, I'm glad that Junpei-san is himself again. Yeah, me too. How you doing, bud? Oh, I'll be in my room today, but let me know if you're going to Tartarus. Now which one should I buy? Okay, so I literally could have gone to Tartarus today. Shit. Go to bed early? Yep. Your condition improved because you rested. Oh, how sublimely the heroine Murasakino Uie is portrayed in this passage. She was written to be the ideal woman of the high-end period, the quintessential high-end beauty. Speaking of high-end beauty, there's a question for you. Here's a question for you, Katone. The chief criteria of high-end beauty was the length of a woman's hair, though cosmetics were important too. They used white makeup, plucked their eyebrows in favor of drawn-on ones, and colored their teeth with limonite. But do you think men did these things? They did both. I suppose it was an easy question. It was a unified style. Whether man or woman, every adult sported this fashion. Even though the white power was lead-based and unhealthy, they wore it to uphold their standards of beauty. Compared to them, you guys are. You gave the correct answer. Your charm has increased. Classes have ended for today. Ah! Hey, Akihiko. Let's hang out. Sone, what are you doing? Since you have the star persona, Santanta, you might be able to become even closer. Spend some time after school with Akihiko? Yep. Alright, let's go. Akihiko seems somewhat happy. Iwatodai Strip Mall Hagakure Ramen. Well, let's eat. You and Akihiko chatted over steaming bowls of ramen. You feel that the bond between you and Akihiko seems to be growing stronger. Oh, okay, not a rank up. You decide to return to the dorm. The dormitory lounge. Amidst your friends, you see Ryoji.
Oh, welcome back. You're late. Ryoji-kun was just leaving.
Katone-chan!
Welcome back. Shame you weren't here. I was hoping I'd be able to see you.
Well, I'm here now.
I'm sorry, but I gotta get going. I'll come see you again.
Okay, bye.
See you later, Ryoji.
I just came down the hall.
Was that Ryoji-san?
Yeah, he said he was going home.
What was he doing here?
He's been coming here a lot ever since he started hanging around with Junpei.
But visitors aren't allowed here.
Yeah, but Mitsuru-senpai said it's okay during the day.
I don't think we need to worry about Ryoji-kun.
And that automatically makes me think we have to worry about him.
He's dangerous. Who? Ryoji-kun?
Come to think of it, he was hitting on Mitsuru-senpai the first time he met her.
I mean, he did that to all the girls, though.
But having him around us really cheered up Junpei-kun.
Well, it's not like moping around is gonna bring her back.
Yeah, sadly.
That's true.
What's the matter, Ai-chan?
I envy you, Junpei. I'm a machine, so I cannot understand how it feels to live.
But you don't seem that different.
However, it is more accurate to say that I am functioning as opposed to living.
Yeah, that's fair.
There are times when I malfunction, but I can always be repaired.
So if we were all like you, we wouldn't have to worry about dying. Sorry. Hey, I don't have time to talk. I seriously gotta go study.
Wow!
Hey, shouldn't you guys be studying too? I heard math's gonna be a killer.
You wait until now to tell us that? Well, I guess we should call it a night then.
Your friends have gone back to their rooms.
I should not possess the gift of life. A living weapon is difficult to operate. However, I believe I understand the concept of loss.
Yeah. Katone-san.
Should you ever be harmed, I...
Don't worry about me.
I'll try not to. You are very special to me. I do not know why, but I always want to be by your side.
Aw, we'll be friends for a long time, I guess.
I want to protect you. I apologize for interrupting you.
No worries, I just got home.
I will leave you to your studies. Good night.
Meanwhile...
Ryoji Mochizuki is dangerous. What is this uneasiness? I am a machine. I cannot die, so they won't have to grieve for me.
Oh boy, what's she up to?
I must do something.
Oh, this is not good.
I don't want them to suffer anymore.
Well, I guess we're not going to Tartarus tonight. Aiga-san doesn't seem to like Ryoji-san. I agree that he is a bit strange, but I think he's okay. I mean, I don't need to, but I'm gonna go study. You don't think you can get any smarter than you are. You should study tonight before going to bed. You don't think you can get any smarter than you are. Are you still going to study? Yep. You have decided to study. Your academics have increased. You feeling sleepy. You have studied enough for tonight. You are no longer in great condition. It is finally lunchtime. Oh, Katone! Do you have anything planned for after school? I don't think so. Well, let's hang out then, if you don't mind. I want to talk to you about something. See ya! Seems like Yukari doesn't have much to do after school. Maybe you should spend some time with her. Lunch break's almost over. You decided to return to your classroom. Classes have ended for today. Sorry, Yukari. I know you asked me first, but I have to drop everything for Ryoji. Katone-san! Hey, can you come with me? There's somewhere I want to go with you. Ryoji invited you out. Since you have the fortune persona Fortuna, you might be able to become even closer. Will you spend time after school with Ryoji? Sure. Okay, thanks. Ryoji seems happy. Gekkogan High Rooftop. You can see the entire city spreading around you. All the way to the ocean. Hey, why is the city so beautiful? The city, the sea, the sky, they're all full of light. It's a big city. I see. I wonder if there are other cities that are as beautiful as this one. Ryoji gazes off into the distance. My eyes hurt. My body hurts too, for some reason. What's wrong? I don't know. For a long time, I haven't understood anything. Ryoji looks down sadly. Please, don't forget me. No. Forget me. Wait, don't forget me. I won't forget you. Katone-chan. Ryoji's lips are trembling. When I think about you, I hurt inside. It hurts. Ryoji seems to be in turmoil. You sense Ryoji's serious feelings. The Ryoji Mochizuki Social Link has reached level 9. Your power to create personas of the Fortune Arcana has grown. Please, forget it. When the time comes, forget what I said. Forget me. You let the scene on the rooftop with Ryoji sink deep into your memory. Afterwards, you head back to the dorm.
Sup, dude?
Tomorrow's the full moon. But we don't have any shadows to kill. Man, this sucks. That reminds me. Ryoji didn't seem like his usual self today. Looked like he was about to start crying. Maybe he's been studying too hard. Nah, that can't be it. I don't know, man. He seemed pretty depressed. Also, hi, Ken. What's the matter, Katone-san? Since you have the Justice Persona Archangel, you might be able to become even closer. Spend the evening with Ken? Yeah, sure. Oh, okay. Well, let's go. Ken seems happy. You and Ken step out to go get dinner. Why don't you choose where we go tonight, Katone-san? Anywhere you want. I'll pay. Huh? Ken? Huh? Ah! Oh, he's one of my classmates. A boy about Ken's height walks by. What are you doing?
Nothing. I'm just about to go get dinner.
This your sister?
Huh? Oh, no! What are you getting mad at?
What are you getting mad at me for?
Because I'm not her younger brother. Katone-san is. She's my.
Ken falls silent with a troubled look on his face. We're friends, right? That's so weird.
Well, what's weird?
I mean, she's way older than you.
Shut up! Don't be ridiculous! Stupid!
Your face is stupid!
Dumbass! Hag!
Dumbass! Hag! Ken's classmate runs off. Did he just call you a hag?
I'm sorry he said that stuff. I'm sorry.
Didn't bother me. Ken hangs his head low.
You and me, we're nowhere close to each other's ages. I know that already. That's a fact that can't be changed. So, why are you bothering with a kid like me, Katone-san? The guys at the dorm are older than me and you have lots of friends, right? Then, why me?
Ken looks downwards, but he has a serious expression. You must be honest with him. Oh, God. They both sound terrible. Okay, because I am not into that. I'm gonna cheat a little. Your special friend is the right one. That sounds gross. But apparently that's the platonic one, according to a guide I just looked.
Katone-san, you call me your friend. And I'm a special friend too? Even though I'm just a kid? I can't be there for you like everyone else. And you still... Thank you, Katone-san. You're very kind, after all. I really look up to you. You're so kind and so strong. I want to be more like you.
Ken smiles. You sense a strong bond has formed between you and Ken.
The Ken Amada social link has reached level 8. Your power to create personas of the Justice Arcana has grown. Thank fuck this wasn't romance. Oh god. Oh! I forgot that I had homework. I'm sorry. I'll just get something quick to eat and go up to my room today. Well then? Ken's face has turned bright red. Ken ran off. You decide to return to the dorm. Good morning. I intend to do my best to protect everyone. Something wrong? No. Please do not worry. I just wanted to share my feelings. Class is ended for today. This is the student council room. Since you have the emperor persona, Fornius, you might be able to become even closer. Would you like to spend some time after school in the student council room? Yes, please. You have decided to spend some time after school in the student council room. Gekkogan High School student council room. Chihiro's the only one here.
Katoni-san, today's meeting was canceled. What happened to Yudetoshi-san?
What do you mean?
Just now, a teacher called him to the office. The teacher seemed really upset.
Chihiro seemed scared. What could have happened? You decide to go to the office. I mean, that's the only way we're going to find out, right? Gekkogan High School office hallway. You hear someone yelling inside the office. Don't be so stubborn! Just put her name on the list! Katone-kun was chosen by the president to be in student council. She's very responsible. That's why I don't consider her a suspect. You hear teacher Enhida Toshie talking. There are witnesses who saw her wandering the streets at midnight. A high school girl wandering the streets at night. There's only one explanation for that now, isn't there? I thought you hated students who don't know the rules. I don't doubt that there were witnesses. But I believe in Katone-kun. So I'm not adding her to the list of suspects. Besides, I thought we were talking about the smoker. Your accusations of bad behavior. Are you trying to slander her? What exactly do you intend to do to her using this list? In the end, you're just an adolescent interested in the girls too, huh? I never thought you'd fall for a girl. Forget about our deal. If you'll excuse me then. You were listening. Hidetoshi looks uncomfortable. I'm not the culprit. I know. You don't have to tell me. Hidetoshi seems satisfied. That teacher thinks it was you. Did he really pass his certification exam? Well, don't worry, Katone-kun. Even if the whole school turns on me, I won't sell you out. You feel a strong sense of friendship with Hidetoshi. Your relationship is stronger now. Rank 8. The student council social link has reached level 8. Your power to create personas of the Emperor Arcana has grown. Be careful of that teacher. You don't seem to realize why he's got his eye on you. If something happens, call me. See ya, Katone-kun. Interesting. A teacher has it out on me. I don't know why. I mean, it wouldn't be the first time in real life I've had teachers who just didn't like me for whatever reason. But, yeah, no, I've got no clue. You decided to go back to the dorm.
Hi, how was your day?
It was okay. Tonight is the full moon, but we won't be conducting an operation. Maybe I should summon Juno, though, just in case. By the way, have you seen Aegis?
Isn't she in her room?
Aegis has been returning late these days. She never used to. I wonder what happened.
Earth! Koromaru is wagging his tail. Is he bored? Koromaru is looking at you pleadingly. spend the evening with Koromaru? Yeah, sure. Woof! Koromaru looks happy. Woof! Woof, woof! Koromaru is frolicking happily. Koromaru picked something up. It's a mad bull. Cool! You decide to go back to the dorm with Koromaru. And the midnight hour. Or the dark hour, rather. Meanwhile, at the Moonlight Bridge. It is the dark hour, and a figure on the bridge looks up at the moon. Another figure approaches it.
I've been looking for you.
Oh?
What are you doing here?
Well, to answer your question, I ended up here when I came to my senses.
So she was right, there is something about him. But whether that means that he's dangerous or not, is still remains to be seen.
It's strange. The sky and the ground look so weird. And there's no one here. Something terrible has happened here. And yet I feel at peace.
Have you forgotten?
Forgotten what?
The dark hour. A time period few people are active during. But you've somehow adapted to it. Too well for a human, in fact. Yes, it's all so clear. Now, I understand the reason behind this feeling I sense when you're around. You are not good. You are my enemy.
Your enemy? Enemy? That's right. On a night like tonight, the moon was full. It was long ago.
Interesting.
Yes, we met once before.
Oh, okay. Now we're starting to get interesting.
As adversaries.
Who am I? Who are you?
I am Aegis, the last remaining anti-shadow emergency control weapon. A machine created to destroy shadows.
Created to destroy shadows?
And you, your true name is Death.
Is he Pharaoh? Am I right? Is he actually Pharaoh's?
You are the shadow I sealed away 10 years ago.
Yes, it was 10 years ago. The night I was born into this world, I set foot on this very bridge.
The sole purpose of my existence is to destroy shadows. It is for that reason that I was given a personality and a persona.
I am the 13th Arcana. I was never meant to be.
And the 13th Arcana, if memory serves, is death. And that's based off of the lessons that we learned during summer.
Everyone called me Death. But when I was born, a part of my power shattered and was strewn about. As a result, I was incomplete.
Even so, you were far stronger than I anticipated. Since I could not defeat you, my only option was to seal you away. Under the circumstances, there was only one suitable vessel. A human girl who happened to be nearby.
Oh. Interesting. Does that mean Katone?
I had no other choice.
Katone. Wow, I called that.
I see. I was inside her all this time.
And yep, that means he is Pharaoh's. He's gotta be Pharaoh's.
And I unwittingly led her to my 12 missing pieces. And then... I see. I understand now. remember everything.
Oh boy. Is that good or bad?
Who and what I am.
A machine is created for a purpose. Mine is to defeat you. That is the purpose of my existence.
It doesn't have to be that way. I guess.
Palladian!
She apparently feels differently.
Don't be foolish, I guess. I'm different than before. There's no way you can win. I'm sorry.
Aegis was knocked back without setting a finger on Ryoji. Aegis's chassis was heavily damaged from being slammed to the ground with such force.
I'm sorry. This mission appears impossible. A machine that cannot fulfill its purpose has no worth.
Aww.
I'm sorry, everyone.
Kotone-san.
I'm scared.
Meanwhile, in the dormitory command room, Fuka has summoned Junto, and Mitsuru is manning the equipment nearby.
Juno! Wait, did something happen?
Yukari, is something wrong?
Well, it's a full moon tonight. You noticed it too, didn't you, Senpai? Jeez, I'm starting to feel like a workaholic.
Right? But hopefully they're gonna find Aegis.
Oh no, did something?
We don't know anything for sure. However, we can't find Aegis.
Huh. Where would she have gone?
Trying to pick a fight with someone on a bridge.
I sensed a persona, but it quickly disappeared. And soon after that, I couldn't detect Aegis's presence.
So maybe we should go to the coordinates and check things out, yeah?
Could it have been Strega?
Well, she hasn't sensed any of their members, but we can't be positive.
I've confirmed Aegis's location. She's on the Moonlight Bridge.
All right, call the others. Let's see what's going on there.
You rushed to the Moonlight Bridge. Aegis's body is heavily damaged. Parts of it are strewn everywhere.
Aegis!
I'm sorry. I remember everything. Who I am. Who he is.
Aegis stretched out her worn hand. You gently took it in yours. Katone-san.
I know why I wanted to be by your side. I'm sorry. I failed.
It's gonna be okay.
I'm sorry.
There's no need for you to apologize.
You?
Ryoji-kun? Wait, what are you doing here? Aegis
is no longer moving. It seems she stopped functioning.
What's going on?
It's all my fault.
What? You did this?
Shouldn't we be asking him how the fuck he's moving around during the dark hour?
Akihiko, wait. He's not showing any signs of aggression. Tell us, who are you? What are you?
I'm the same as the beings you call shadows.
I recognize his voice actor. I think he plays Teddy in Persona 4. Which is hilarious if you think about Teddy's story.
You're a shadow?
I'm the embodiment of all shadows. The Appriser. Born from the union of the 12 Arcana.
The Appriser?
Yeah, and because we killed all of the other Arcanas, he's back, I guess.
I remember everything now. the frightening truth about myself and shadows. It's all so hard to believe.
You know the truth about shadows?
I do.
What?
The shadows are here to facilitate the rebirth of the maternal being. The maternal being will begin to awaken as she is drawn to me. The appraiser.
You. You're the appraiser?
That's right.
What is this maternal being?
She is a great entity. There is no comparable word in your language for her. 10 years ago, a man collected a great number of shadows and contained them in a laboratory.
Yep, that's Mitsuru's grandfather.
That's where I was born. But the unification was interrupted, and I awoke in an incomplete state. Not long after, I fell to Aegis, as she did to me.
Aegis? Is that true, Ryoji?
She knew she could not defeat me. So in an act of desperation, she sealed me within a child who happened to be standing nearby.
And that child was me.
That child grew up, carrying me inside her. And by a twist of fate, she later returned here, as a transfer student.
You mean...
Everyone's looking at you in shock.
Yes.
Katone.
I lived inside her.
Ryoji was... inside of you?
Inside her?
Her special persona awakened.
And that explains it. That explains why Thanatos suddenly appeared on the rooftop when her persona awoke. It was him. Thanatos is the most powerful persona of the Death Arcana. So Pharos was Ryuji. I was right.
As did the 12 shadows, all in order to become one with me.
Ryuji's the appraiser?
Yeah, Junpei just can't catch a break. First Chidori, now Ryoji.
And he was inside her body? None of this makes sense!
Right?
It's all my fault. I'm sorry. There's more I need to tell you.
Ryoji-kun!
Well, apparently he is not going to tell us tonight. Ryoji lost consciousness and fell to the ground.
He appears to be exhausted. Let's let him rest. We have Aegis to attend to as well. We'll continue our talk later.
Well, shit. You are in shock at what you've just heard. Ryoji lived inside of you for 10 years. Waiting to make contact with the 12 shadows. And the boy named Pharos was actually Ryoji. So many questions remain unanswered. However, Ryoji is unconscious. You took Ryoji and Aegis home. Classroom 2F. Mitsuru walked in.
He's awake now. Let's meet tonight on the 4th floor.
Roger, Dodger.
Okay.
All right then. I'll see you later.
Damn that Ryoji.
The dormitory command room. Everyone has gathered. Ryoji is sitting on the far sofa, hanging his head.
Is everyone present?
Are you okay, Ryoji-kun?
Yeah, I'm okay. Thanks. Besides, there's more I have to tell you guys.
Ryoji-kun.
There are many questions we need answered.
Shit. Dropped something.
To begin with, you said shadows were here to facilitate the rebirth of the maternal being.
Yes, he did.
Please elaborate on this.
The maternal being is called Nyx.
Okay.
Who the hell's Nyx?
He just told you, the maternal being.
Nyx is the mother of shadows. In ancient times, she bestowed death to this world. If she is awakened, darkness will once again cover the land and all life will vanish.
Well, that doesn't sound very maternal.
All life will vanish.
Are you saying everyone will die?
It would be more accurate to say that everyone will forfeit the will to live.
So what, we'll basically just be like dolls?
Are you talking about the lost?
Or, yeah, you know what, the lost works. Everyone seems to be coming to the same conclusion. Every human being will become like the lost, leading to the extinction of mankind and the end of the world.
The fall.
But it's still possible to keep it from happening, right? What? There's no way to prevent it?
I'm sorry.
Aww. He's a villain, but he's not a willing villain. He legit doesn't want to bring about the end of the world, and he feels responsible.
Wait, what are you apologizing for? Are you saying it's for certain?
Yes. You heard the bell. I'm the appraiser. The appraiser of death. My existence is the affirmation of the fall.
The affirmation of the fall?
Everyone's at a loss for words. It is inevitable. The entire human race will become members of the lost. Ryoji's existence confirms the impending extinction of mankind. That can't be.
When? When will it happen?
I'm afraid you will not live to see spring.
Damn! That soon?
But that's not too far away.
Like, we're talking about 3 months? Because we're in December now. Spring doesn't generally happen until March. So damn. So technically, actually, it'd be closer to 4 months. But even still, that's not a lot of time. How are we going to stop this?
What are you guys freaking out about? All we have to do is defeat this Nyx.
You make that sound easy. Chances are, it probably won't be that easy.
And that won't be a problem, because we've never lost.
Not necessarily true. We had a couple of losses, but whatever. I'll agree with Junpei.
Defeating Nyx is impossible. It has nothing to do with strength, ability, or power. Just as all living things die, and the flow of time is continuous. Nyx cannot be defeated.
What? That's bullshit!
This is all so sudden.
Right? The others are startled.
I was born from a collection of shadows. But now, I have a human form, so I can talk with you, laugh with you, cry with you. All gifts I received because I was inside her. Of all the people on Earth, it was she who carried me. Thanks to that, I am able to give you a choice.
A choice?
Nyx's coming cannot be avoided. But it is possible to live in peace until she arrives.
Okay.
You'll have to kill me.
So wait a minute. How will killing you ensure that we will live in bliss until she arrives?
If I were to disappear, all memories of the Dark Hour would disappear with me.
Okay.
As would any recollection of the fate that awaits you.
And then what, we just die?
You won't remember anything. The coming of the fall will be instantaneous, and you will not suffer.
We'll forget everything?
You'll be able to return to your normal lives. And in doing so, the time until the fall will be slightly delayed.
How slightly are we talking?
In essence, I am the same as Nyx and cannot be killed. But thanks to her, there's a part of me that's human. So if death comes from her hands, I think it may be possible.
Ryoji is looking at you. Oh, no, 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 no,
no. No, God, please, no, no!
No, 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 no. Not happening, buddy.
Ryoji-kun.
If you don't kill me, you will suffer more than you could ever imagine. With no hope for salvation, you will live every day paralyzed by the fear of your impending death.
Yeah, and how is living without knowing about it any better? Yes, it spares her feelings, but it's still gonna happen.
And I don't want you to have to endure such pain.
I could never kill you, dude.
You're so kind. I'm sorry to put you through this.
I don't want my memories to be erased. To forget everything would be like hiding from the truth.
Yeah, that's literally what it would be.
Would that really be such a bad thing?
Yes.
All that awaits you now is despair. You don't know the terror of absolute death. Please, don't make your decision without at least thinking about what I've said.
Oh God, it's gonna be one of these things. Don't give me your answer now. You have until X date in order to give me the answer, and then I will ask for a decision. Oh boy.
Why is this happening?
Ryoji silently stood up.
You don't have to decide right now. You have until December 31st.
Yep.
New Year's Eve to think about it.
Yep, called it.
After that, I'll dissolve into the blackness of the dark hour and become intangible.
Ryoji.
I will disappear with the coming of Nyx anyways. So don't worry about me. I'll be back on New Year's Eve.
Okay.
Hey, Ryoji, wait!
Ryoji is gone. He just disappeared. Just like Pharos.
Ryoji-kun.
We will see him again on New Year's Eve.
Ryoji's revelation was all too devastating. The world will soon perish. That mankind will perish. The only option you are given is the right to choose how to die. Death is inevitable. The appraiser truly brought about a death sentence. You cannot think clearly right now. How does a person choose the way he will die? Well, all that happened.